An option, in simple terms, is the right to buy or sell a set quantity of a particular security, like a stock, for a set price within a specified time frame. The selling party is known as a writer, and the buying party is the holder, who purchases the option for a fee or premium. Options essentially fall into two categories, calls and puts. A call option gives you the right to buy a certain number of stocks, for instance, at a fixed price known as the strike price. They are typically issued with 3, 6, or 9 month expirations and can be bought and sold at any time before expiration. For example, say a company's stock is trading at $45 per share, and you anticipate that it might continue to rise, so you decide to buy a call option that expires in 3 months that will allow you to purchase 100 shares at a strike price of $50. For this privilege, you pay the writer a premium of $2 per share for a total of $200. Now, if the price of the company's stock rises above $50, you are considered to be in the money. Let's say the price reaches $55 per share after 1 month. You have three possible courses of action. You can do nothing and wait to see if the price continues to rise. You can exercise your option, or you can sell your option. If you decide to wait, there is a chance that the price could keep climbing, increasing your potential profit. However, you also take the risk that it could fall, perhaps even below the strike price of $50. If you decide to exercise your call option, you will pay $5,000 for the 100 shares. You could then hold on to that stock or turn around and sell it in the market at the current price of $55 per share. This would result in a profit of $300 when you take into account the premium you paid. Or, rather than exercise your option, you could sell it. Since an option's value is derived from the underlying asset, the stock in this case, the value of the option has risen along with the value of the stock. The option, therefore, can be sold in the market for a higher premium since the value of the option has risen with the value of the stock. You may be asking yourself, if I want to take advantage of the potential growth of a company, why wouldn't I just buy shares of stock rather than options? There are a couple of important reasons. First, remember that each option represents 100 shares of company stock. Instead of buying an option representing 100 shares, you could buy 100 shares of stock outright, but your out-of-pocket expenses will be far higher. For instance, if you purchased the shares in the earlier example, you would pay $5,000 for the stock rather than the $200 for the option, giving you the right to still participate in the appreciation of the stock. Also, purchasing an option doesn't expose you to the full loss of purchased stock. If you purchase the stock for $5,000 and the company goes bankrupt, you could stand to lose $5,000. However, if you purchase a call for $200, the maximum amount you could lose is $200. Keep in mind that any profit made on options investing will result in capital gains taxes owed. Also, options aren't free. In addition to a commission fee, many brokerage firms charge a separate contract fee per option purchased, exercised, or sold. Since options are tied to the value of their underlying security, option investors should understand the risks that accompany them. Extremely volatile stocks will in turn have extremely volatile option price movements. Also, even though call options' downside risk is limited, investors can still end up losing their entire investment if the call expires unsold or unexercised. An option account can be opened at Zions Direct for qualified investors. Call our investment center to learn more about whether this is the right investment approach for you. To continue building your investment knowledge, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.